Hi, this is Ian Hultquist, and we're here at South by Southwest premiering Animals, which I had the good fortune of scoring. And you're watching the AU Review.
This is your first time here in the film portion. A little different for you.
Yes, it's been cool to kind of have a change of pace down here. It's funny because you still have that anxiousness in the air, but the crowds are definitely smaller, which helps.
At least for the film, I mean, interactive's happening now, and that's probably the most attended event out of everything.
I didn't realize how big it was, actually. I always assumed that film would be like the big cats here, but interactive has really taken over, which is, it's cool to see. I'd be curious to see what South by Southwest becomes in like 5 more years, if they kind of like split up more or something.
Well, you've seen it grow over the last, you know, 6-7 years, however long it's been since you first started coming here.
Yeah. The first year I came was 2009. My band Passion Pit played a couple shows, and I had an amazing time. And then I came back in 2011 with a side project of mine called Aceland. And those 2 years alone, it just seemed like a completely different festival. It seemed like it had grown like 3 times the size. It was a madhouse.
It has. I mean, I came in a similar time and can certainly attest to the same. Now, let's talk about the film. Mm-hmm. I guess to start with, you know, how did you become involved in the project?
Yeah. I met David Dasmouchen, who is the writer and star on a set for one of our music videos, actually, for Constant Conversations. Mm-hmm. And I'm a huge Batman fan, and he was in The Dark Knight, so I immediately just kind of went up to him and became friends. And as we talked more, we kind of told each other about what we're doing, and I said that, you know, as outside of the band, I'm doing film scoring. And he said, well, I have a script that I might be making to a movie. And that's really how it started, and that was summer, like 2 years ago or so. So I've actually been lucky enough to be part of this for a long, long time. But yeah, that was like the very first budding of it.
And it goes back to Batman.
Yeah, it always goes back to Batman.
the origin story.
Yeah, exactly.
So being involved from such an early process, such an early point, you know, at what point do you actually start getting involved in the scoring of it? You know? Mm-hmm. Because normally the film will be, you know, at least shot, and then you'll sit down and you'll score it. But were you playing around with music for it well before that point?
Yeah, you know, it was an interesting process on this because I started writing music almost as soon as I got like a script. I think like that fall after we met. But you know, I wasn't like fully scoring the movie until I had it in front of me, which was earlier this fall. Mm. So it was kind of funny where I was like, I was always scoring it, but it wasn't like every day I'm sitting down like, okay, I'm scoring right now. It was just kind of like, I'm going to be writing different pieces of music for months and months and months and like coming up with sounds and ideas. And, you know, we would be on the phone every other week talking about different ideas between me and Colin Shifley, the director. So it was kind of a cool thing where like I always had it brewing, but it wasn't until honestly just a few months ago where I really sat down and it was like full on every day, let's get this done.
Were you given a sort of directive of this sort of stylistic approach that, you know, he wanted you to take, or were you given a bit of free rein, at least in those, you know, early stages, to mm-hmm. kind of take it as you thought it should go?
It was a lot of freedom on this, which was cool for me because being one of the first features I've scored, I got to kind of figure out what I thought might work. Mm-hmm. But Colin and I would meet up a few times. Actually, last January, we did like a very preliminary location scout. So my wife and I flew out to Chicago, where I actually grew up as well. And we just kind of drove around the zoo all day, drove around the city, and just talked and talked about like movies we love and like things that we'd want to try to put into this. Mm. So that kind of helped form ideas. The other thing for me was that it's such a realistic movie. Mm. Like you're like in the car with them the entire time. So I wanted to try to come up with a score that wouldn't intrude on that. And honestly, the first time I saw a cut, which is like a really rough assembly cut, it was like 2.5 hours long, and there wasn't any music, and I was actually like, this is great, guys. Like, I don't know if you need me still. But
there's an ambience to the film.
Exactly, yeah. And you don't want to cut into that, which I think is it's a tricky thing to do, and I think if you can pull it off, like, you've done your job well. Mm. But I think that we're all really happy with where it is now. It finally got put together into a finished product.